Recording in progress.
Winner, 5 minutes in the locker room, winners first, total length.
As soon as the coach comes this way, it's 30 minutes long. Don't know why, but...
Thank you.
A reminder for those joining us for this press conference, Kansas will go first. Total length of this press conference is 12 minutes. And the Kansas locker room will be open for 30 minutes a minute. Coach Roberts joins us. Jalen Wilson led Kansas with 20 points, his 21st 20-plus scoring game this season. Grady Dick with his first career double-double, 19 points, a career-high 11 rebounds. This is Kansas' 16th straight NCAA tournament first-round victory dating back to 2007, and their ninth straight opening-round victory in double figures. Their seventh consecutive tournament win dating back to last season. They are 46-13 as the number one seed, including a 17-0 record against the number 16 seed. Kansas 50 points in the first half, tied a season high. No, I asked for. Yeah, we need at least four ASAP, please. Okay, we're going to start this press conference shortly. Just a reminder to silence your phones. Recording of this press conference with your tablet or iPhone is prohibited. Please identify yourself with your name and affiliation. Raise your hand. Microphone holders will come over to you if you have a follow-up. Please tell the microphone holder, again, the length of this press conference is 12 minutes. Pleased to have with us Kansas assistant coach Norm Roberts, and congratulations, coach, an impressive win.
Thank you very much. Give them a lot of credit. Howard has a good team. God, they're good. They can shoot. They have length. They play faster than I think we even thought they would. And in that second half, I don't think there wasn't a foul call for about 5 minutes, and it was just up, down. Our guys were begging to come out, and I think their guys were just as tired.
This time we'll take questions front row for athletes and coach.
Grady, it was your first career double-double. Were you aware of that, and how do you feel about doing that on the big stage? And I have a follow-up.
It was special. I mean, it's obviously my first one, so it means something. But, at the same time, I think I kind of knew towards the end of the game, but I was just kind of trying to use the face guard in my advantage and try to get some rebounds where guys couldn't really see me, so just trying to do.
KJ, could you comment on Grady's play, and also both of you, like Norm said, it was a fast up and down game. Was it great being out of the Big 12 conference and playing a game like that?
It was the Big 12 really prepared us for moments like this and games like this, and Grady probably had a little breather. They weren't face guarding him as hard as usually teams were, so he got a little breather, and he just makes good shots, and that's what he did today and got on the boards.
Other questions for our head coach and student athletes? In the left side, go ahead.
Yeah, KJ, what was the – I know you like to get up and down, and today was clearly an up and down game. What was the fun factor for you out there today?
Just being out there with my guys. This is one of the biggest stages you'll ever play in, so just being out there in general is the best part. And then, of course, when you go up and down and fast pace, fast scores, it's really fun to be out there, and just the environment is amazing.
We're going to go, Greg,
Please.
Greg Eklund, this is for Kansas Public Radio for Grady. Your first NCAA tournament game, what was the feeling like during warm-ups and everything leading into this game?
It was great. I mean, this is, you know, growing up in Kansas and going to a lot of the open practices when they were in Kansas City, it kind of just, you know, made me want to, you know, be in there, you know, one day, and that was my goal. And, you know, to actually be in here and get my first taste of some March Madness is, it's special to me and, you know, my family.
Other questions? Front row again.
To the guys, when did you find out Coach Self wasn't going to answer the call today because he's still recovering?
We'll go
and have a follow-up.
Go with KJ first and Grady.
We found out prior this morning. He's just day by day, just taking it time by time and just doing the best he can to make it out here.
Yeah, just what KJ said, and back him up day by day. And, you know, he's doing doctor's wishes, and hopefully, you know, we get back and, you know, hear from him first thing and what he liked out there and, you know, what he didn't like. So
I was just wondering, in a game that fast paced, do you get more tired than any other game this season?
I mean, there was a little part of it where I was, you know, pretty exhausted. But you know, those are the most fun games when, you know, you're going up and down and anything can happen. And we just, you know, need to, when those times like that happen, really just buy into that defensive side, and including me for sure.
Going to go in the back on the aisle, then we'll come to you over here.
Brendan Dorzinski, WIBW Radio in Topeka. Grady, this one's for you. Early in the game, Howard was shooting lights out, especially from deep. At one point, I think they were almost 56% from the floor in the first half. What changed for you guys defensively that led to tougher shots for them and then runouts for you guys on offense?
Just our preparation for the week. We knew, you know, I think they had four guys over the season that have shot over 100. So we just knew they were going to come out blazing. And, you know, hats off to them because they did exactly that. But I feel like we just had to, you know, adapt to the game and really just try to run them off the perimeter. And I feel like we did a better job throughout the game with that.
Mantra Dave, DT. Coach, this a lot of transition play both on your side and for them. Was that a part of the game plan or something that you guys adapted to on the fly?
No, we always want to play fast. We're better when we play fast. I thought Juan had a game that's not really like his type game. He doesn't turn the ball over like that, and I think he got fatigued, and he made a couple of bad passes. We made a couple of wrong adjustments too, but we like to play fast. They got up and down, and we knew if we could rebound the ball, which we didn't do a great job of that today, but if we rebounded the ball, we could get out and have some opportunities, and that happened today.
Other questions for our coach or student athletes? Please raise your hand. You cannot record this. Okay. It's name and affiliation first, please. Thanks.
Nigel Dice with KCCI. Great. Question for Grady. How special is it to be a Kansas native? And then obviously you have a chance to help your program, you know, repeat back-to-back national championships. How special is it to have this big of an impact on this team as a freshman? How special is all this?
Oh, it's super special. You know, it's always special when you play at Kansas. But, you know, like you said, me being from here, I think, you know, it means even more to my family and seeing my siblings go through here. You know, I've been on campus since I was little. So the fact that I got to be in the shoes to play for this university is a dream come true.
Front row.
Coach Roberts, did you feel like today you were more animated, if that's the right word, compared to the Big 12 tournament? Were you more personally fired up because of the, you know, the importance?
Probably a little bit. Probably to say I wasn't would be wrong. Yeah, I probably was a little bit more animated today just because we knew what they were capable of doing, and we didn't guard it right in the beginning and let them get off too many easy looks and got beat back door. Those are things that we had discussed, said we didn't need to have happen. So I probably was a little bit more animated.
And what's today's update on Coach? Could he possibly coach the next game, and how's he doing?
He's doing good. It's all day-to-day and how he feels and doctors and stuff, but he's doing well. He's been able to spend quite a bit of time with the guys and practice and that type of stuff, so he's doing good.
We have 6 minutes left in this conference. Other questions for the coach or athletes?
This one also for Grady. You did a tremendous job today, you know, rebounding. How do you always try to find yourself to be in those spots to get those, you know, pretty much game-defining rebounds? I think, like, those are pretty much like the start to a lot of your guys' runs. You know, there was even a one where you got the offensive rebound, you kind of dished it off for an assist. How do you always find yourself in the right spot for, you know, whether it be offensive rebounds or defensive rebounds?
I say, you know, throughout the season, I've got, you know, great advice from my coach Brady Morningstar, and he played here, so he's kind of been through what kind of goes into if your shot's not falling. You know, you got to try to find ways to affect the game. You know, fortunately it was falling pretty good today, but at the same time, I was just trying to, you know, see how the defense is guarding me. You know, if they're face guarding me like they were a couple possessions, and that kind of gives me advantage to, you know, see the rim and, you know, a full view, and they can if they're, you know, looking at me. So it was a good advantage for me.
Other questions? Okay, we're going to go in the aisle.
KJ, Grady, y'all got some of the guys who get maybe don't get to see the floor as much in at the end of the game. Can you talk a little bit about what they contribute to you guys as you go through the postseason and their importance to kind of that team culture?
Yeah, all the guys, especially Bobby and Joe, all have a good energy that helps the team no matter what. If it's practice or playing in the game, they always help us in energy points and just knowing the game and helping us when they're on the bench and when they're out there. So it's just good to see them get a little bit more time than they usually do.
Yeah, it was great. I mean, when you got, you know, a whole team that wants, you know, one goal, you know, that makes the team great. And throughout the whole season, those guys have been, you know, helping us. And I feel like we've been, you know, striving to just be one the whole season, and we've done a good job of that.
Any other final questions? Okay, in the back row, okay.
Hey, Coach, Scott Chasen, KC Star. What was the best part of Kevin McCullough's game to you? And I have a follow-up on that.
Everything about how Kevin plays. Kevin plays to win. He does all the little things, be it cutting to the basket, be it offensive rebounding, making the extra pass, and then he's a terrific defender. So, you know, Kevin would be, if you put a quote by him, he's a winner. He's a winning player. He makes winning plays all the time, and it's not always making a basket. He makes winning plays.
And then Grady and KJ, following up on that, the way he thinks the game, is there something different about his mental approach both on offense and defense with Kevin?
Yeah, I mean, when you have, you know, his intelligence, and he just, yeah, like Coach is saying, he just knows how to play the game, and he sees a lot of things that not a lot of basketball players see, and we see that throughout, you know, his experience with college basketball, and even, you know, throughout scout and film, he, you know, always knows the answers and stuff like that. But that's just a great piece to when I'm, you know, struggling with something throughout the game, I know who to go to and ask for advice.
Yeah, I think Kevin's just a mastermind basketball. He's obsessed with coverages and defense and knows how to get in certain areas that a lot of people don't think when they switch to zone, go to man. He's always on top of the stuff, and he's just a floor general. When he's on the floor, it makes everybody better and helps everybody know their assignments even more clearly.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Best of luck. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Again, the Kansas locker room will be open for another 18 minutes. We'll have Howard up here shortly. The satellite coordinates for this press conference, Galaxy 17, transponder 16A, download frequency 12006.5V. Edwards right behind us here. Yeah. We're going to begin our second press conference here very shortly with Howard. Again, a reminder, recording this press conference with your tablet or iPhone is prohibited. If you're joining us on Zoom, please raise the hand function for questions. Silence your phones. If you have a question, please raise your hand. Microphone holder will come to you, and please, before you ask your question, give your name and affiliation. The satellite coordinates, again, are Galaxy 17 transponder 16A, downlink frequency 12006.5. The length of this press conference will be 10 minutes. And the Howard locker room will be open during this time. Thank you. Joined by Howard head coach Kenneth Blakeney, to my immediate right, forward Steve Settle, and Shai Odom. At this time, coach, we have an opening statement on your thoughts on the game.
Thank you. First, I'd like to give all the glory and praise to God, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. I'm just so incredibly proud of our guys, and what I told them after the game was that, you know, besides having a historic season, being a part of a group that is only the third team in the history of Howard University's men's basketball to go to the NCAA tournament, I just love how they have grown as people and have become better men over this course of the season. That's a victory that no one can take away from us. And I'm thrilled that we were able to represent Howard University in a classy way that honored so many people before us, the legacy of Howard, and so many people that's going to walk those steps afterwards. So thank you.
This time we'll take questions for the head coach as well as our student athletes. Okay, front row here.
Adam Kilgore with the Washington Post. I was hoping to ask this both Shai and Steve. I understand that Vice President Harris came in and spoke to you guys after the game. What was that experience like, and what did she tell you guys?
Start with Shai first.
The experience was amazing. It's amazing to know we have people of such power that are, you know, affiliated with us and supporting us at the same time. She just told us that, you know, even though we didn't come up with the victory, that we're still winners, and what we've done this year is history, and to just keep our heads up.
Steve?
Yeah, just to have someone like that with such stature in our corner and behind us, supporting us, it means the world. And she just told us how proud she was of us and the whole Howard community, how proud we make them and how much we're talked about. And just told us to keep our heads up and keep pushing.
Coach, would you like to add anything to that? Okay. Any other questions? We have a Zoom call in the back.
We have a question from Chris Heidel. Chris, when you're ready. Christopher, are you there?
There you go.
Go ahead.
Yeah,
please.
I got you guys. Hey, this is Chris Heidel from Herbers from Radio. Sorry for the loss. What does it mean for you guys playing on this big stage, you know, being on, you know, national TV, and what does it mean for the brand for Howard?
Is that directed to anybody in particular? Coach, you want to answer that?
Well, we've had a lot of games on national TV, but certainly being in the NCAA tournament, there's more eyes and visibility on you, which is amazing because we have a chance to talk about our university as one of the greatest universities on the face of this planet. We're the 83rd university ranked in the country, and we have a legacy of leaders from every different sector of the world in terms of occupations and jobs. So it's pretty cool to have this opportunity and moment and to highlight our university and to share with the world how great of a place Howard University is.
Go ahead, question.
This is for Kenny. I'm sure you guys came into this game expecting, believing you could compete and win. When you're up, you know, 5 minutes left in the first half or so, does that belief sort of go up a little bit? Could you sense your guys really start to believe that could happen at that point?
Well, I think, you know, understanding that we've had leads and I had the lead at that point in time, there's still more game to go. So it's like we can't get too high and we can't get too low. We have to kind of stay even keeled. I mean, you know, as of a couple, maybe a week ago or so, Kansas was the number one team in the country. And, you know, they do a great job with their coach, you know, Hall of Famer Bill Self. And I know Norm, Coach Roberts took over today for Coach Self. Hope he has a speedy recovery because we really need him back on the sidelines. But for those guys to, I think for our guys to compete in the way that they did, I'm very proud and honored to have a chance to say I'm their leader or their coach, their mentor, or their teacher. So they took us on an incredible ride, and it's been a lot of fun.
Question in the back row.
Dave Campbell, Associated Press. Steve and Shy, I guess, what allowed, in your mind, Kansas to be able to pull away a little bit late first half, and what sort of what makes them so good? Now you get that first-hand look.
Start with Steve first.
I think when you play a team like Kansas, they capitalize off all of our mistakes. We left a lot of meat on the bone in the first half, free throws, gave up a lot of second chance points, and a team like that, you can't get that up. So I feel like we did a good job at first, but they were able to spread the gap.
Yeah, just like Steve said, in both halves, giving up a lot of points in transition and second chance opportunities, we kind of dug ourselves in a hole. That's pretty much it.
On the aisle there.
For Steve, what are you going to take with you from the season the most, do you think? Like, what's going to stay with you the most?
Well, I think for me, I've had to learn how to impact the game in other ways other than scoring. I think that's been the most valuable thing for me. I feel like coming into this season, I just thought of myself as a scorer, but Coach KB and my whole team challenged me to become something more than that, and that has only made me so much better. Coach BS pushed me in practice and in the season just to make me more well-rounded, and that's just going to make me reach my potential even more.
Stay on the left side on the aisle. Go ahead.
This is for Coach Greg Eklund for Kansas Public Radio. Coach, I mean, nobody plays a perfect game, but Steve referred to the mistakes. Did you feel that you had to play almost a near minimum of mistakes to have a chance to win this game?
Well, I thought that they did a few things really well. One is they did an excellent job in transition and was able to get opportunities that were highly efficient opportunities. They did a great job, I think, on their pick and roll stuff with Harris and Adams running around, look like almost like Stockton and Malone a little bit. They were really efficient in that. And you know, they did a great job of second chance points. So points in the paint with all of those three layers added up really made an impact in the game, and it was too much for us to overcome today.
About 4 minutes left in this press conference on the aisle.
Tough ending today, but it's been a really impressive season for y'all, and you've accomplished some of the goals you set out for. What are some of the things you're going to take from today and from this journey to kind of come back next season and attack it with that same vigor?
Coach?
Well, I mean, I think there's a lot of different things that we want to try to unpack from this season. Certainly, I think we understood how to win this year, and that is a very difficult task to learn. You know, we have some things that I want to talk to each individual about when we have time, some goals and some things that I'd like to see them do over the summer. I like to apply tasks to our guys, so some tasks that they will have over the summer, and see if we can kind of after that, can we connect to see if we can grow and connect to kind of ignite this thing all over again?
One final question. If not, thank you very much, Coach. Congratulations, athletes, on a tremendous season.
Thank you, Mike.
Thank you.
She got the rest for Howard.